Good morning, children. Today, in this class, we will discuss about chapter number 2, that is land, soil, water, natural vegetation, and wildlife resources. Children, the topic name is land, soil, water, natural resources, and wildlife resources. Children, this is the second chapter. Previous topic we have discussed about the resources, right? Now, let us now come to the chapter number 2. Land, this class will concentrate about land and soil. What is land? How you have been using this land? And land use pattern in the outside the world? And common property resources, land degradation, and conservation of land. These are the concepts we will discuss. As you know, land is one of the finest example of natural gift. One of the best example for natural resource. It is 2/3 of the area covered by land. This land is unevenly distributed in the different regions. Some places we can find densely populated, more population. Some places you can find very sparse population. Sparse population due to mountain regions, valleys, desert areas, dry regions, tableland, plateau region, and area covering with forest, etc. Therefore, we can find low population. The places like plain region, that means near river valleys and fertile soils, coastal regions. Plain region, you can find densely populated. So therefore, at the same time, this land, the most important natural resource, this can be using, we have been using this land in different ways. Land, we have been using in different purpose. We have been using for construction, for agriculture, for constructing industries, right? And we have been extracting minerals, fossil fuels, mining activities, agriculture. So we have been using this land for the different purpose: agriculture, mining, industry, construction of roads, construction of highways. So we have been using many ways, right? That is the importance of land. At the same time, just now this land uses, we have been using the land by extraction of minerals from the crust, by construction of various buildings, by performing activities like agriculture, by different methods, by construction of railways. These are the common uses. These are all termed as a land use. Normally here, the land can be classified into two ways. Normally, children, you see, the land is a natural gift. But here, it can be subdivided into two ways. One is private land and second one is community land. Number one is private land. Private land relates to a particular individual owner. Private land. An individual is the owner, But many people have various properties, private properties, land, houses, buildings, vehicles. There are many examples, private land. In the another angle, you see, community lands, the land which belongs to public, government. There are certain places which belongs to the community. For example, library, burial ground, parking places, bus stations, water pond, wells. These are all the examples, the best examples for common community resources. So these can be considered as a common property resources. This can be considered as a common property resources because it is not owned by individual. It is belongs to a public. So it belongs to public. So land here can be classified. One is private and second one is community resources. Community resources or common community resources. Yes. These are the two types. Now coming to the land degradation. Yes. As you know, land is covered, I said, 34% plain region, 27% plateau region. So the land is covered by different way, relief features, mountains, plains, plateaus, etc. And this can be degraded. Degradation of land. Degradation of land can be happen due to two ways. One is human activities, by involving human activities. And second one is the natural activities. Degradation of land takes place due to human activities. Number one is human activities mean construction of houses, extracting of minerals, digging of the fossil fuels. So due to these activities, so the degradation takes place. Land degradation takes place. Natural, this is due to human activities. And natural ways, yes. Due to natural, you take as a weathering or erosion, soil erosion, landslides, floods, tsunami, volcanoes, earthquakes. These are the best examples for land degradation. Example for land degradation by natural activities, by natural forces. So degradation can take place two ways. One is by human, by involving human activities. Second one is due to natural forces. Due to natural forces. Now children, you see, now coming to the conservation of degradation, land degradation is. So if you continuously a portion of land degrading takes place, so this is really a problem for future generation. At the same time, here degradation of land main thing is major. One is extension of agricultural activities. Extension of agricultural activities. And the second one is the construction of industries. Second one is construction of industries. Due to these two main activities, degradation takes place. Now let us learn. You can ask, sir, is there any ways to conserve this land degradation? Yes, why not? There are many ways to conserve, to control this land degradation. There are many ways, there are many methods to control the land degradation. What are the methods? Yes, deforestation. Okay, controlling of use of fertilizers, pesticides, controlling of overgrazing. Okay, by doing these activities, we can control land degradation. We can control the land degradation. That is. So here, the land is one of the finest examples for natural resources. Land is a finest example of natural resources. Children, one is land and how we have been using the land. Then common property resources. Under the common property resources, you can say the land can be divided into two ways. One is private land, second is community land. One is community. One is private land, second is community land. Private land belongs to a particular individual. He is the owner. They have right to enjoy. So whereas the community land belongs to the public places like public resources like library, parking, burial ground, playground, bus stations. These are the, you can consider the common community resources. Common community resources. That's what we are discussing. Common property resources. The last one is, there is degradation. Land degradation. For land degradation, the two major components, one is agriculture and construction of buildings, extension of buildings in urban areas especially. Expansion of houses constructing in the urban areas and extension of agriculture in the rural areas. The two factors responsible for land degradation. The two factors responsible for land degradation. One is agriculture. Second one is construction of houses, construction of industries, particularly in urban areas. So, to control these, we can apply various methods, that is deforestation, controlling of overgrazing, and avoiding of pesticides, use of pesticides and fertilizers and pesticides, and planting of trees, construction of check dams. These are the various methods we can apply to control the land degradation. To control the land degradation. That is land degradation and conservation of land. Conservation of land. This is the children. First one is land. Right? So, land is one of the finest example of natural resource. Previous topic we have discussed already. What is resource? Resource nothing but as a everything is available in the environment which can be satisfy our needs, technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable. That is the definition of resource. Otherwise, simply you can say resource is nothing but as an environment which surrounding us an object. Which surrounding us an object. But all the features are there surrounding us is very, very essential to survive of life. That is what is environment. Environment is which surrounding us as an object. So that is so, land is one of the most important resource. And here you see in the previous land use pattern, the same land also, land use pattern different in different countries. In the world wise, if you take the land use pattern, the countries like USA, China, Canada, Australia, France, India, Mexico, they are given how much percentage of land area under crop area, cropped area, how much area, how much percentage of area comes under patches land, how much area comes under desert region, how much percent of area comes under not utilized for land, not used for anything. So they give a very clear picture, children. So by seeing this picture, we can also read, yes, so and so country is highest percentage of cultivating agriculture in this year. We can go through it, yes. So that too depend upon environment. Okay, what is required? So there have been various countries occupying so much percentage of area due to various climatic conditions. So all those things again due to what factors? One is topography, climate, soil. These are all the factors responsible. Altitude. These are all the factors responsible for this event. Land use pattern series. Which are the factors responsible for cultivation? Various factors. Topography required, climate is required, soil required, altitude. So these factors makes different. Children, is it clear? So this is the about the land. Land is one of the most important resource. Clear? Now we'll see about soil. What is soil? Soil is a loose material. Soil is a finest particles which occupy on the topmost layer of the surface. It's called as soil. Soil is an organic matter which helps to grow different plants on the surface. The soil will be formed due to weathering. Soil is formed due to weathering. What is weathering? What is weathering? Weathering is nothing but as breaking up of rocks due to various natural forces. Breaking of rocks due to various natural forces, due to temperature, due to rainfall, due to snowfall, due to glaciers, due to landslide, due to running water. It breaks and forms. So ultimately this loose soil material becomes decomposed, becomes humus that helps to grow different crops, different plants on the surface. That is what is soil. That is what is soil. Now how it is soil formation, we will discuss next class. Okay, children, thank you.